I'm not walking again, no. I'm out of this place. Hey, I can't walk. Me, le shema. Hey, I'm gone, no. I better be hungry. Di bolugi. Oh, my shemi le she. Ah.
Thank you.
Ah, yay! Mrs. Tokpe! Mrs. Tokpe, please! What is going on? Are you alright this time?
Alright, I'm not alright. How can I be alright? He needs help.
That's what you're here for.
Hey!
Help him!
He's not my own kind of help. He needs psychiatric help.
Mrs. Tokpe.
He gave me a dead slap. I'm leaving.
Mrs. Tokpe, I'll double your salary.
Mrs. Tokpe, I'll double your salary with benefits. Look, build house on top of Aja water. I'm not working. Thank you, yeah. Well, so you know that I'm serious. Take your clothes. I'm not working. Ah, yay.
What can I do for you, Wilson? What else can I do for you? I've done virtually everything, everything I know.
Take it easy on yourself.
Where am I?
You are at a hospital. Just relax. Relax, relax.
My head. My head. So
easy,
much.
Easy.
My head. My head.
Sorry, sorry. Okay? Yes, I know.
Oh, God.
Your husband beats you up again. Mrs. Anita, you need to get a lawyer and file for divorce. You need to leave this man before he kills you. Look at you.
If I leave him, he'll kill us.
Yes.
I can't do that.
Good for him then. You need to do what you need to do. Leave him. Sorry. Sorry.
It's okay.
Of course I did. I guess he was too cute.
Get up! Get up! I will kill you! Get up! I'm not done. I don't want you. I said get up! Get up! Can you hear me? Get up!
can give up. Oh, Anita. Anita. Oh! No, 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 no. Mr. Jacob! Mr. I need help. I need help, Anita. Anita. Oh, no, no. Oh, Anita. Oh, my God. Mr. Jacob. Oh, no, no. I need help. I need help. Mr. Jacob. Someone help me. Mr. Jacob.
So I brought you here.
It wasn't his fault. I wanted to run away. It's a little.
You do not need to run. Face him with a lawyer. Get a divorce. Please. You need to save your life. You need your life.
Oh my, no problem, no problem. Let me get the cleaners. It's okay.
Concerning the advertisements that I saw in the Hong Kong newspaper about the month.
Oh, great!
Yes, I am actually available for the job. I would have called you. I called you weeks ago, but I got no response. I should have followed up. I just had some sympathy. Yes, I'm actually ready. I'm capable. I'm capable for the job. I can do it. I can take care of a paralyzed man. I'm ready. I am tolerant. I'm patient. I'm everything you want me to be. I can do it.
All right then. Where are you coming from?
I'm coming from...
Don't lie to me, you whore! You've not been in this house for the last 15 days.
No, I went to the hospital. The hospital.
You think you can lie to me? You think you can lie to me?
I'm not lying. Joy took me to the hospital, not lying. Not lying, Joy. Joy took me to the hospital. I'm Joy, yes.
Joy. Joy.
So, can you start today?
I'm so sorry, Ma. I can't really start today. I'll start in a few days because I have so many things to take care of at the moment. But I promise you, I'll come as soon as possible.
Okay. Where in Abuja do you stay?
I stay in Wusetu. Yes, Wusetu.
You don't seem sure.
No, Ma, I'm sure. I'm very, very sure. Ma, please, I need to know if I'll be having accommodation in your place if I come to work. Please, I need to know.
There wasn't. But we will see what we can do.
Thank you so much, Ma. I am so grateful. Thank you. This means a lot to me. I'll be there as soon as possible. Thank you. But I have to hide all this crap at this. I don't want this man to kill me.
Good afternoon, Ma. Good afternoon, Ma. Good afternoon, Ma. Good afternoon, Ma. Ma, I'm here. Good afternoon, Ma. The nurse is here. Hello? Hello?
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Anita. I'm the nurse. I'm your nurse.
Are you mad? I ask you to come in here.
I'm sorry.
Shut up! Out!
I'm really sorry.
Shut up! Get out! Out! Shut it off!
Get out! Get out! Mom, you will just come na. You can't go again. What's your...
Hello, Ma. Yes, I'm at your son's place. Yes, I saw him, but he wasn't pleasant. In his exact words, he told me to get out. Yes, Ma. Okay, Ma. Bye, Ma.
You can't go now. Where are you going? No one can go again. Madam, can't go. Found, guide me through the storm.
my guiding light. Handle me with care when I'm falling down. When I'm falling down.
That's it.
Sir, your lunch is served. Sir, your lunch is served. Do you want me to feed you?
I want a bath. I want a bath. Right now. Ow! Don't peel my skin.
This is just too much. This is too much. He's just been so wicked and just so mean, and I don't know what I did to deserve this. He's just been so wicked. It's like jumping from frying pan to fire. I don't know.
Go!
Baby, have you been crying?
No.
Oh, I'm good.
I'm so sorry.
A trip came up unexpectedly, and I had to make it. I'm sorry I couldn't come back when I said I would. I clearly don't have to ask how things have been around here. You cleaned up. Nice.
Well done.
Thank you, ma.
Please, Anita. Stay. Don't leave.
While I know my son is a lot to handle, I will ask that you stay still. Please, Anita, stay.
Please. Okay, ma.
Thank you.
He asked for food.
Oh, really? Mm. Okay. Go for it then.
Thank you. Thank you, ma.
God bless you. Wilson. I raised you better than this, Wilson. I raised you better than this.
I don't give a rat's ass how you think that you raised me. What is the point in trying to raise someone when in the end we all get to live how we choose?
Four nurses in 4 weeks. Four nurses! This one just came 4 days ago. And you already have her in tears. Oh, you think this is funny? I am so upset at you, Wilson. I am so upset at you. You have to consider your current behavior and change for the better. I can't live with you. Because of your attitude, not just to strangers, but to family members also.
I'm not interested in living with you, Mother. I've never been. Leave me alone.
You won't eat proper food, but survive on packets of biscuits? You throw a mess when food is brought to you? You maltreat your nurses when they serve you your medication? What exactly do you want me to do?
Kill me! Kill me! Just kill me! Enough! Do it! Just do it! Alright? Just do it! Do it right now! Do it! Do it! You just do it! Do it! You won't do it. You won't let me be.
Good evening, Mr. Jacob.
Joy, how are you?
I'm fine. And how is your wife?
I don't know. I think she's fine where she is. I was hoping you could tell me where she is.
How would I know?
Well, the last time I spoke with her, she said you took her to the hospital for 15 days or so.
And for the 15 days or so, where were you and what were you doing?
I was looking for her. Yeah, I was.
Really? In a bag filled with bottle of whiskey? Mr. Jacob, you have abused us several times. And now I decided to step in. And you could not even give a reasonable account of the whereabouts of your wife. She's a beautiful woman deserving of love. But sadly, you do not love your wife. Else, you will not hit or harm her in any way. Listen, Of course, I know you want to give me reasons why you hit her and all that, but it's not enough. It's not enough for you to beat and hit your wife. There are so many ways you can resolve issues with your wife without beating her. Anyways, I'm just a neighbor who do not know the whereabouts of your wife. And honestly, I wish she never comes back to you.
Leave me alone. Do you hear me? Leave me the hell alone. Else I will torture you. I will torture you till your spirit breaks, till your mind crumbles, till you leave me the hell alone! Leave me alone! Go! Get out! Stay out! Leave me alone! Get out. Get out. Get out. Stay out!
Right in the mirror with care.
when I'm falling.
Can you hold me?
In the silence, I hear a voice say, keep holding on, but the dawn will break, the pain will fade.
Do you realize that you're stupid? Doctor. And a nuisance, that's what you are. You had the effrontery to make me soup in place of a proper meal. Soup! Ah!
Your mother said that you liked soup before dinner. So I am actually making dinner for you.
Stop talking about my mother! She's a rat's ass! Is my mother here right now? Is she here right now? That woman gave you stupid advice. A lot of advice of stupid you. A total waste of nature's face in this universe. You took that stupid advice and then made me soup. And how do you expect me to take soup in place of food? You expect me to eat it? Oh, go ahead. Up. Because that's where you belong. On the ground. That's where you belong.
You can scream at me. You can insult me. You can call me all sorts of names. But it's fine. It's okay. You can make me feel like a fool, but it's fine. I will not leave. I will stay here and take care of you. I am not going anywhere.
Soul is my solace. When my hope is found, guide me through the storm. My guiding light, handle me with care when I'm falling down. When I'm falling down. In the silence, I hear a voice say, you are the very reason.
reason I exist, man. I won't, I promise I won't lay a hand on you ever again. Please, forgive me. Hello? Hello? My love, speak to me, please.
Listen, Jacob. Listen. We cannot be together anymore. Please move on. Move on and find someone else. I'm sure that you're going to find a woman that you deserve, that will love and respect you. I'm also going to find a man that I deserve. Please just move on and let me be. I don't think we're meant to be for each other. Please, just move on. I beg you. And stop doing this. Stop calling me. Please stop calling me, Jacob. Please.
You will. If you've been cheating on me. Oh, man. I should have killed you. Yeah. I should have killed you when I had the chance. You cannot go free to be with your lover and make a fool of me. No. I will kill him. I will kill you. I will kill Joy.
Listen.
And then I will kill myself tonight.
Listen to me and listen carefully. Leave Joy out of this. She has done nothing to you. Leave her out of this. Listen, I have told you. Move on. Just let me be. Just move on with your life. You're not meant to be anymore. Just move on and just stop calling me. Please, Jacob. Please.
No story for the gods. If you can hide, hide well. Oh, I promise you, Anita. Everyone you care about will die one after the other until you come back to where you belong. I promise you. Oh, I promise you. Starting with Joy. I see now where she's got the guts to talk to me. In short, you know what? In short!
Hello, hello. Hello, Joy. Joy, you have to run away from your house. You have to leave your house right now. Right now. He wants to kill you. Jacob is going to kill you tonight. Please, just run away. Run away. Leave the house now, please. Please.
Oh. Okay. I would like to see him try. Go to sleep, darling. He won't do nada.
No, Joy. You don't know Jacob. He promised. He promised to kill you. He told me that he's going to kill you. Joy, please do me a favor. Please, for the sake of our friendship. Leave the house right now and Jacob will kill you. Please.
And Anita, I said sleep. Go to bed. He's not going to do me anything. Are you safe, dude? That's all I need to know.
Fine.
Anita, I need to go to bed, okay?
Okay, good night.
Need a shoulder. Somebody to tell me it's over. Darkness, I feel lost, like a sheep without a master. I know deep inside there's a light that shines bright. Hand me with care when I'm falling down. Your shoulder's my solace when my hope is found. Guide me through the storm. My guiding light, handle me with care when I'm falling down. When I'm falling down, in the silence, I hear a voice say.
Have you had something to eat?
No, I've not, but I will have something. Thank you.
You should eat something.
I'll eat after attending to you, sir.
Sit. The scar on your left arm. How did you get it?
I fell in the kitchen.
It is quite strange for people to fall on sharp objects in the kitchen. Very strange. However, I take your response. Just you and I here, just do it. Take my life, kill me. Please, please. It's just you and I here, can you just do it? Just kill me.
Why don't you do it yourself? Hmm? Why don't you do it yourself? Huh? Why don't you kill yourself? There are 1,001 ways to kill yourself. Pick one and do it. Who do you think you're fooling? Who the hell do you think you're fooling? Me? No! You're so selfish. You're so selfish. You're so wicked and self-centered. You're not even thinking about your poor mother. No! You're thinking about only yourself. Only yourself. You're so selfish. Look at you. Do you know how many people? Do you know how many people out there in the world will appreciate this attention you're getting? No! Do you know how much they want a sister, a brother, a friend, a colleague, or a lover, even a stranger, to love them this way? No! You do not value this because you're selfish. You're mean. You're so self-centered. I have news for you. I will not kill you. I will not kill you! If you want to die, you do it yourself! I'm sorry I yelled at you. I'm sorry. But I'm not sorry for what I said.
Anita. Anita. Sit. Sit down. You see, life be quite tricky. Sometimes the people that you wish love for so much are the same people who are jealous of what other people have. I may just not experience what you call gift. What's gift? What is the value of gift if you cannot put it to use? What is gift? And then you talk about love. Love made me this way. Love brought me here. Love put me in this position. For I loved wholeheartedly, I loved with every fiber in me, someone who was jealous of everything that I am. My brother. My only brother. My mother's son. Yet he was jealous of me. My mother knew about it. I chose to do nothing about it. This is all our fault. This is all because of love. You know, when people often say that parents aren't meant to have favorites amongst their kids, in my mother's case, my brother was an obvious choice. Oh, he was her favorite kid. She loved him so much, showered him with so much love and attention that she spoiled him silly. My father, on the other hand, he was a perfect father. Oh yes, he loved us, but very strict. He was so strict that you could never tell amongst his kids which was his favorite. And so he passed on. And when he passed, he willed his company to me. And then willed his estates to my brother, who sold all of that. Took the money, ran away, went into drugs. As for me, it was like I had been prepared all my life to sit in my father's chair and run his company smoothly. And so I excelled. I was successful. And now before you ask, oh yes, I tried. I tried to get my brother on the right path. I tried to get my mother, to get him to be on the right path, because I know how the story goes. I know that when he hits the ground, he becomes a burden to us. And yes, it happened. He hit the ground. And then he came running to me. You wouldn't blame him now, would you? I am his only sibling. He came asking for help. He kept asking for money. I had to help him. Because I love him. Without love, I loved my brother. With every fiber in me, I loved him. I gave him monies. And of course, he took off with that money and spent it on drugs and illegal businesses that went south. And then he came back again. And this time, I declined. And on this day, I was traveling and then my tires gave way. I woke up and found myself in the hospital. My two legs hanging in the air. I was told that I couldn't walk anymore. I tried. They tried the best they could help. I was shipped abroad to get medical help. All to no avail. What love?
What happened to you?
Law caught up with him. After necessary investigations, he was arrested and then sentenced to life in prison. You see, my mother loves me so much now. You know why? Because she just realized that I'm all she's got. Now, did it have to come to this? No, it wouldn't have if she had just listened to me. You put him in check on time.
I'm sorry.
No, you shouldn't apologize. You didn't do it. My brother did. My neighbor's CCTV camera caught him. Loosening the bolts of the two front tires of my car. And the next day, I had an accident that has changed my life for the worse. Look at me. I have nothing. I lost my company. I lost my poultry business. My fiance left me. I mean, look at me. Who wants to be with a man who's paralyzed? I have nothing. I'm pretty sure my father will be turning in his grave right now, seeing what they've done to me. You see this house? This house right here is the only thing that I have. So you won't blame me if I tell you that I have nothing to live for.
I'm so sorry. I'm really sorry. Maybe you were fighting the wrong battle.
What do you mean?
You thought your brother was jealous of you. But he was envious. Jealousy and envy are not the same. When someone is jealous of you, they have something that they don't want you to have. But when someone is envious of you, they don't have that particular thing and they don't want you to have it.
Your brother was so envious of you. He was so envious of your success. He wanted it so bad. But you know, you would have helped somehow. You don't use the same method in tackling envy and jealousy. With the knowledge you know now, you would have handled it better. You know, in this world, they all talk about jealousy, jealousy, jealousy. They think jealousy is the only parasite, but it's not. There's something called envy. And envy is very deep.
So how would I have been able to tackle envy? See.
First, you should have just not fed into his ego. He had a huge ego and he kept feeding and feeding and feeding the ego over and over and over again. If you had done that, you would have helped. You wouldn't have gone this way. You didn't know. You know, I've been reading your books. Yes, I've been reading. And it's been so good. I've been reading it while I've been here. And I like it.
I used to love to read. I used to. I'm tired. Thank you.
You called me.
I'd like to get some air today.
Okay.
Thank you.
Need a shoulder. Somebody to tell me it's over. Misery and pain, like a shadow they remain, sucking life out of life, leaving scars no one. In darkness I feel lost, like a sheep without a mast. But I know deep inside there's a light that shines bright. Hand me with care when I'm falling down. Your shoulder's my solace when my hope is found.
Then I began to think that it is very true, which is commonly said, that the one half of the world knoweth not how the other half liveth. For as labor cannot produce without the use of land, the denial of the equal right to use of land is necessarily the denial of the right of labor to its own produce. Shall you complain who feed the world? Who clothe the world, who house the world? Shall you complain, who are the world, of what the world may do, as from this hour you use your power, the world must follow you.
Try.
is found. Guide me through the storm and be my guiding light. Handle me with care.
Mm-hmm. Wait for it. Aha. And?
I give up. I knew you were going to excel here. You're a local breed.
Ah.
So it is normal. It's expected for you to excel here. Enjoy yourself.
Of course, I will enjoy my win. Yeah!
You're happy now.
I will enjoy. Okay, let me just pity you.
Babe.
You what?
Hey. Mom.
Beyonce?
Mom.
Good afternoon, welcome.
I can see you're having fun already on your birthday. I brought you cake and a new suit.
Mom, another suit. You have gifted me so many
Happy
suits.
Happy birthday, son.
Thank you, Mom. I hope I get a time to try this one on.
Well, seeing you are in a good mood, why don't you try this one today?
I probably would. You would help me, right?
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Anita.
Yes, Yes,
I'm happy seeing my son smile. You know, I haven't seen that in a very long while. You must be the reason for that.
I don't think so.
I will appreciate it if you don't fill my son's mind with hopes of falling in love with you when you won't stay with him.
Ma, I don't even know what to say.
I know love has a way of healing. Unreturned love, however, has a way of breaking down. You met my son. Light up his life. I understand that as a mother. I should be worried because if you leave, or rather when you leave, you would have done more harm to my son, to me, than the help you came to offer. I will not watch that happen and not prevent it. You will not leave my son to fall in love with you and get paid a salary and leave when you're tired of attending to him. I won't let that happen. Because you would have been long gone. And I'll have to find a way of making him smile again. And you know, naturally, my son is not an easy person to deal with. I am tempted to sack you right now. Ma, please, please, no, ma. Please, please, I beg you. Please, don't do this to me. I beg you. I don't know where else to go to. I don't know where to go to. Please, I beg you, don't do this to me. Please.
Get up. Are you promising to put things in check then?
Yes, I will.
You can go.
No matter what I do, all I think about is you. Even when I'm with my boo, you know I'm crazy over you. No matter what I do, all I think about is you.
I like that song. I like that song. I really do.
I heard you humming that song yesterday. In the bathroom. Really?
No. Like, you show me? Nah.
No, I heard you yesterday humming the song.
Oh.
Oh my God. But of course you're a good singer. Okay, do us a song.
No, Mom. Oh, no, don't do that. I can't sing. You know
what? Okay, I will read you a book. So sing. Sing. I mean, it's just a song. Are you shy?
Of course I'm shy, because I can't sing.
Can you be shy, my son? How can you say you're shy?
Okay, fine, I'll sing.
Okay.
Boy.
So prove to her
you're okay, now shy. This is the deal. No one's going to laugh. You laugh, I stop singing.
I cross my fingers.
We'll do that also.
Okay, let me have your hand so that I squeeze them hard if you laugh.
Okay. Those pieces don't break my voice.
Anita.
Wilson, your breakfast is served. Her number is not reachable. I wonder why she just up and left. Wilson, please try and take something into your system. You've been like this all day. Please, eat something. You know you are all I have. I don't want you to starve yourself to death. Take something into your system. Please, honey, eat something, okay? Wilson?
Where have you been? Where did you go? You got that divorce, didn't you?
How did you know?
I heard some of your phone calls. I see the scar on your arm. And I know that there is an abusive husband somewhere. Even though you refused to talk about it.
You're unbelievable. Yes. I did. Mm-hmm. The court ruled in my favor. Yes, I got a divorce. Yes.
Why?
I also had to see Joy. You know, he had threatened to hurt her, and I had to just see her to make sure that she was fine. And so how I came back to Abuja and bought my plans. 5 years now, I'm finally free. I'm finally free. I'm free to love you.
Exactly why I refused to talk about your husband. Because I didn't want to be part of the reason you left.
What do you mean?
I have fallen in love with you. But yes, I have come to love you. But I know you can't love me back.
doctor.
Look at me. I can't love you the way you would love to be loved. I can't do anything with you. I can't make love to you. I can't even promise you anything. What can I possibly do for you? I'm not gonna have you give all that love, attention and care, and all I do is take. And take from you. Okay. I know how I feel right now, and I also know how hard this would be. But I'll ask that you go. And love someone else later.
No. I choose you. I choose you. You. I choose you. Not until now, I couldn't even see the light at the end of the tunnel. But I see it clearly now. I see it so clearly. I have found hope. I have found hope in you. I have found hope in this house. I have found hope in your books. I have found hope in you. Are you just going to let me go away? Are you going to chase me away? Are you?
It will be too much of a sacrifice to ask of you. You know that.
In you I found freedom. In your love I have found freedom. We can actually work this out. We can do this together. We can find a way around this. Without you shouting all the time. Get out! Drop it! Shut up!
Come on.
Get out! All the time!
I'm sorry. I don't know how I was able to keep up with all of that. That was something. I'm sorry.
It's okay. We can do this together. We can work this out.
You're sure about this?
Mm-hmm.
You're sure?
Yes. Again. I've been thinking about something. I think you should tell your story to the world on YouTube. I mean, someone out there can learn from your challenges, your story, what you've been through. You could motivate or inspire someone out there.
To the world?
Yes, to the world.
No. You're serious?
Yes, I'm serious.
Much more. I can't believe we're going to do this.
Mm-hmm.
You must tell me why I listen to you. I don't know why I listen to you, Anita. Why?
Because you love me, and I love you too.
I love you, baby. Okay, fine. You win. Let's do this.
So, you start this way.
Yeah.
You say your name first and say, "Welcome to my YouTube channel, guys." Then you can talk.
That's how it works.
That's how it works.
Okay, good. Let's try. Hey, guys. How you doing? My name is Wilson Johnson. And you're welcome to my YouTube page. Alright, so today I'll be sharing something quite interesting, though personal, but could be inspiring.
Have you checked your
boots? Please don't remind me of my foolishness.
Oh, sorry.
I'm so sorry, I'm late.
That's it. Mom.
Where did you come from?
Mom, he had business. But it's fine, he came by us.
Anita can speak, right?
Welcome, Mom.
Where have you been? And why did you leave without saying a word to anybody?
Mom, she spoke to me about.
Obviously, Wilson, you will not allow this woman to speak for herself.
Anita, come with me.
I thought you listened to me and left for good.
I went to take care of some personal things.
Excuse me. That's your pay for 3 months. I want you to pack your things and leave.
I've only been here for just a month.
That will tell you how much I want you out of here.
No, I'm not leaving. I love your son. I love him so much. I'm not...
Well, I'll be damned.
I am not leaving, not now, not ever.
You have got to be kidding me. How dare you? How dare you, Anita? I asked you to put things in check around here, and you look me in the eye and spew trash.
I'm really sorry if this hurts your feelings. Yes, you told me to put things in check. I didn't even know what to put in check. You opened my eyes to see that I belong here with your son.
I am his mother, Anita. And I want the best for him. I am concerned about his happiness that I wouldn't want you to carry on in a fantasy that would never be true. You are a beautiful young woman. You can be with another man. Another man better than my son. You have your whole life ahead of you. You will leave one day and that will break his heart and mine too.
I will never leave your son. Never. I love your son so much. I love him. I will never leave him. Leaving him can never be done by me. Never. It can never happen. Wilson is the best man for me in this world. I love him so much. Please. I beg you. Please. Do not come in between our happiness. Please. It was so hard to find this happiness. It was so hard.
Hey, you got it. 1 million views. It's not even after 2 days.
Oh my gosh! Oh my god, this is so good!
What is he excited about?
We put up a video, an inspirational video of Wilson on YouTube. And in barely 2 days, it has over 1 million views already. Wow. Oh my god, this is huge. He's now an internet sensation, and this could start off a career for him in motivational speaking. He could actually be booked all around the world to speak. Really huge.
I need to come on now. Don't get over yourself. Don't get ahead of yourself.
Whose idea was this?
It was hers, actually, but I'm happy that I listened.
This is real, right? Pretty much.
Well, you told my mom about us already.
Mm. Yes, I did.
Mom, okay, I was going to tell you, sorry. Yes, it is real. Yeah.
Oh, there's no problem. I guess I should let go of my worries and be happy for you.
Well, Mom, I think you should be happy. Not that it matters anyway, but you're going to like her. Don't mind me, Mom.
Congratulations, darling.
Thank you.
I'm so excited.
Thank you.
Come, my angel. Come. I'm so happy. You know what? I'm going to go grab some glasses and a bottle of champagne. I'll be right back. Congratulations, my son.
Thank you, Mom.
I'm happy for you.
Mom, you're going to like her. She's a sweetheart.
Of course, I can see. I'm happy for you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mom. Thank you so much. Need a shoulder.
Somebody tell me it's over. Yeah. I told you. Ooh. You are so inspiring.
You do even more.
I love you so much.
I love you much. Thank you.
When my hope is found, guide me through the storm, be my guiding.